Hello student, good morning. Today let's we discuss about the face. In the face, we will see the objectives of our study, our discussion. One is the skin, the next is called superficial fascia and facial muscles, and lastly we having the nerve supply, the motor nerve supply and the sensory nerve supply. And we are discussing about the skin only. The skin extension, where to where it is extending skin. The skin is extending. Above here is our line is there, see. This line is called the adolescent line. Adolescent line is present here. In infants also present, but the infants of the line will be in the downward direction. The adults in the line is going to the above direction. So this is called adolescent line in the above. And the next, in the below or inferiorly, the face is extending up to the base of the mandible and along with the chin. Above is the adolescent line and below is the base of the line and the chin. Next slide. See here, and either side and on each side it is extending up to the auricles, the border of the auricles on each side. Next slide. Sir, here the forehead is present. The forehead is common in scalp and along with the face. So this is about the extension of the face. Here again, the face is extending superiorly to the hairline and inferiorly with the chin and the base of the mandible, okay, and either side with the auricles and forehead. This is the forehead. The forehead is common for the face and the scalp. Next objective, the next one is called as skin. Skin of the face. In the skin of the face, first we are seeing the skin is a very vascular in nature. Very vascular in nature. It is a richly vascular city. It is called as a blushing and the blanching. So what is the mean of blushing and the blanching? For example, if one young boy or young girl, they are smiling, at the time their cheeks will be turned into the pink color. So that is called a blanching, or it is called a blushing. So that is the vascularity of the skin. And next we are seeing the wound bleeding professionally. Means wound, if any injuries occurs in the face, the bleeding will be the severe bleeding will be occurs. And it is rapidly, healing is in the rapidly healing. Rapidly healing means the jaldi kam ho jata. So bleeding is the severe and healing is a rapidly. That is a best for the plastic surgeons. That's why the plastic surgeons loves the face. If they have done any work on the face, the result will be the very perfectly because of the highly vascular city of the face. Then next we have the face, again it contains the sebaceous glands and sweat glands. Sebaceous, what is the mean of sebaceous? Sebaceous means the oily structures. Every time our face is in the oily only. Especially in the young teenagers. The young teenagers, they are having the pimples. The pimples means in the anatomical terminology we call acnes. Because of the sebaceous glands. That's why the face is the oily in structure. The next we have the sweat glands. This is the summer season. If the fan is not there and the cooler is there, every time you are using your kerchief for the cleaning of your forehead, because of the face, the forehead, it contains the heavy amount of the sweat glands. Means entire the face also contains sweat glands, especially in the forehead, it contains the heavy amount of the sweat glands. See, here the face is in the oily and acnes are the common in the teenagers. Here the highly vascular the picture is visible, and here is you can see small, all are the pimples in the acnes. And next is the skin in the larynx. It is called laxity. Laxity means kya? What is the mean of laxity? Laxity means the skin is loosely attached with the underlying structures. That's why we are getting the different facial expressions. So it providing the some loose tissue. So if any infections like in the nephritis, the patient with the nephritic syndrome patient or with the renal edema of the spreading in the rapid, the having the problem in the kidneys, with the patient having the problem in the kidneys, the first the eyelids, these are called eyelids going to the swell, and the next the swelling, the edema will be spreading into the face, and next it will appear into the different part of the body. So the laxity is more present in the face, that's why the edema will be appears in the only the face in the firstly, especially in the eyelids and the renal edemas are the nephritic patients. And next, when the skin is fixed to the underlying cartilage, here this is the nose and this one is the ear. Here the skin is directly attached to the cartilage, and here also directly attached to the cartilage. We have the boils in the nose, ears are very painful. We see in the next slide. See, this is the boil, and here also boils are there, and here also there. Here also, these are very painful. Boils are the very painful, especially in the nose and the ear, because in this place the skin is directly attached to the underlying cartilage. And next, previous slide. See the facial. Next, the facial muscles. The facial muscles are the here is the elastic in nature. All the facial muscles are the elastic in nature. For example, in your body, for the upper limb and the lower limb, the muscles are present. The muscles get attached into the one at the origin from the one bone and inserted into the another bone. It is a natural phenomenon. But in the face, the origin from the skull bones means the facial bones, but directly it is inserted into the face, the skin of the face, when there is a no bony insertion, directly it is inserted into the face only. That's why we are giving the different facial expressions. For example, you are sitting in your classroom, 150 students are present, but teacher will be observe each and every student based on their facial expression. If any student having the doubt, immediately is asked the that student only, because he having the doubt, teachers knows the his facial expression. Next slide. Superficial fascia. Next object is a superficial fascia. Under superficial fascia, it contains the fat sectorial pad. Fat is the sectorial pad of fat, and the except in the eyelids. And second are the facial muscles and vessels and the nerves. So what is the sectorial fat? Normally the face, it contains the fat, but the fat is absent in the eyelids. There is no fat in the eyelids. We come to about the infants, the children's. The children's, you see the cheeks are the very prominent, because this doesn't have in the teeth. They having the only in the sectorial fat. That fat is present in the cheek region. That's why there is a very prominent, and that fat is using for the sucking of the milk. We are eating with the teeth, but the child doesn't having the teeth. So how can he eat? He eat with the means he is sucking with the that sectorial fat. The sectorial fat more prominent in the infants. Then next is the facial muscles. Facial muscles, I will tell you. All the facial muscles get originated from the bony and inserted directly into the skin. And vessels and the nerve. This is the face. Face means obviously separated by the facial artery, and obviously supplied by the facial nerve. So this we will see in the next. Now deep fascia. So here is very clearly written, deep fascia is absent. That's why we are having the facial expressions. If the deep fascia is present, we are not, it doesn't give the any facial expressions. So the deep fascia is present in anywhere in our body. We have the three layers. First is the skin, the next layer is the superficial fascia, the next layer is the deep fascia. Every place is the deep fascia is present. Especially it is absent in the face and the abdomen. Abdomen also doesn't have the deep fascia. But in the face, except two places, the deep fascia is absent. One is called the pituitary gland here. Here the deepfascia is present. The deepfascia is encovering the, it completely cover the anterior surface and along with the posterior surface, like the splitting and they cover the completely pituitary gland. That we call as the pituitary fascia. So that fascia is a very tough in nature. That's why if the patient having any mumps, it is very painful. That we discuss at the time of the pituitary gland. And second, here one muscle is present. That muscle name is called a buccinator. The buccinator also contains the fascia, deep fascia, that is called a buccopharyngeal fascia. That is discussed in the deep cervical fascia of the neck region. Now facial muscles. So facial muscles is present just below the skin. Okay, that's why we call it subcutaneous muscles. And we will bring the facial expressions. And embryologically, the facial muscles are developed from the mesoderm of the second bronchial arch. So one nerve also developed from the second bronchial arch. That nerve is the facial nerve. That's why all the facial muscles are supplied by the facial nerve. Facial muscles and facial nerve developed from the second bronchial arch. And next is the morphologically. What is the morphological? Sir, it is a remnant of the panniculus corneosus. What is this panniculus corneosus? If you are saying the cow, this is the cow. From the neck region, from the chin region to the up to the tail, the cow having the continuationary subcutaneous muscular sheet is present. When just below the skin directly we have the muscles are present. So like seeing the face also we are comparing with the animals. That's why we using the panniculus corneosus. Our face also like a panniculus corneosus. If for example here is any fly is sitting, fly means as a monkey, okay, the fly is sitting in the posterior part of the curve is never hitting with the tail, just giving one wave. The waves are going toward the posteriorly, the fly will be away from that place. So that is a panniculus corneosus. And topographically, the muscles are divided into the six groups. So what is the meaning of topographically? Depending upon the location, the muscles location, we have divided these facial muscles into the six groups. The first one is the muscles of the scalp, and second, muscles of the eyelid, and third, muscles of the nose, and fourth, muscles around the mouth, and fifth, muscles of the neck. How many is here? 1, 2, 3. And sir, whatever the last one? Sixth one. I will explain. That is the muscles around the auricle. Now come to about the muscles of the scalp. The first muscle name is called occipitofrontalis. Occipitofrontalis. It originated in the occipital and inserted into the frontal side. Occipitofrontal muscles of the scalp. So we complete the muscles of the scalp. Now come to about the muscles of the auricle. These are situated around the ear. The first muscle is the auricularis anterior. It's situated anteriorly to the ear. And what is the auricularis posterior? Behind the ear. And third one is the auricularis superior. It is above the ear. So these three muscles are the around the ear. Next we come to about the muscles of the eyelid. So this is called the eyelid. Eye. In the eye, one is called the orbicularis oculi. Orbicularis oculi. It is around the eye. The rounded part. So this one. Orbicularis
Okay.
And second one is the corrugator supercilii. Supercilii above the cilia. Superciliary arch. I will explain the facial norma frontalis, superficial arch. Here in this place, one pyramidal shape muscle is present. That is called as a corrugator supercilii. And the next is called a levator palpable superioris. Levator, it is a elevating. Palpable means it's called a eyelid. Eye. Palpable superioris, it is above the eye. So this part, which is the our eyelid is going up upward direction. That is called the elevation of the eyelid. That is a levator palpable superioris. So this is about the muscles of the eyelid. The next is the muscles of the nose. In the nose, we are seeing the one muscle is the procerus. The procerus is present here. And the next muscle is called compressor nares. It is compressing the nose. Compressor nares. Then dilator nares. It is dilating the nose. Dilator nares. And one more muscle is present here in this place. That is called a depressor nares. A depressor septum. It is called a depressor septum. So these four muscles is around the nose. The next. Muscles around the mouth. Here so many muscles are present. Just listen carefully. Muscles of the mouth. It has so many muscles are present. I will explain one by one. The first one is around the mouth. Around the mouth. That is called an orbicularis. Oris is the means mouth. Here is the orbicularis oculi. Oculi means is the eye. Oris means is the mouth. And then it's levator labii superioris alveoli nasi. This is the largest name in the anatomy. Largest name in the anatomy is in the muscle and overall also largest name, that is called levator labii superioris, means it is elevating the upper lip. Levator labii means it is called lip. Superioris, above the mouth. Alveoli nasae. Alveoli nasae means in the either side of the nose. That is called as here is present. This muscle name is called as a levator labii superioris alveoli nasae. Then next we have the zygomatic minor. Here the two muscles are present. Here the demarcation is wrong, but in this place two muscles are present. This muscle is called as a, instead of zygomatic major, it is a zygomatic minor here. And next, levator labii superioris. It is also for the elevating of the upper lip. Levator means elevating. Labii, upper lip. Superioris, above the mouth. And when we remove this in the part, when we remove this levator labii superioris, then next we are seeing one more muscle. That is called a levator anguli oris. That is in the angle of the mouth. When we are in the sad, our angle going to the downward direction. When we are smiling, the angle going to the broad. That is called anguli oris. Then next, one more is a zygomatic major. Coming here. And then last, again I will repeat it, all these muscles. Around the mouth is called as the orbicularis oris. And one muscle is present in above the, means it is using for the elevation of the upper lip, levator. Labii means upper lip. Superioris, above the mouth. Alveoli nasae means either side of the nose. So this one. And next, here the two muscles are there, small tendons. You can see here also, tendons. This inner side one is called as zygomatic minor. Outer side one is called as zygomatic major. And this is part is called the levator labai superioris. Once you remove this part, then you are seeing the one more muscle, that is called ligator anglai oris. These are you using for the elevation of the upper lip. Then is the depression. Depressors of the mouth. The muscles around the mouth, below part. One is called as depressi anglai oris. It is a depression condition. The angle going to the downward. Depressi anglai oris. Then depressi labai inferioris. There is a levator labai superioris. Here is a depressor labai inferioris. And one more muscle is present here. This is called as mentalis. Here is present mentalis. And one muscle is the for the whistling or puffing, that is called as puccinator. And last we have the muscle is called as rhizoris. Rhizoris is the one more muscle. So these are in the present in the for using for the depression of the mouth. Neck region, one more muscle is present, that is the muscles of the neck. That muscle is called a platysma. I will show you the platysma later. Next, functionally, muscle significance. Functionally, we are seeing the here embryologically, morphologically, topographically. Now come to about the functional. The functionally, there are the three regulators for the three openings. So three openings is the palpebral openings, nasal openings, and the mouth opening, oral fissure. Palpebral fissure, nostrils, and the oral fissures. So three openings are present. These three openings, each opening having the one splinter. Splinter means is called for using for the closing, and dilator for the opening. When the eye, this is called a splinter, this is called a dilator. In the splinter is the one muscle that is in the circular, it is around the eye is present. And dilator is something, it is variable amount is present, means lot of things, lot of muscles are present for the dilators. Best to develop around the eyes and the mouth. Here and here, these splinters and dilators are the well developed. Fissure and the splinter and the dilator. One splinter is called the orbicularis oculi. I already explained orbicularis means the round. Oculi means is called the eye. It is a splinter used for the closing of the eye. Splinter. And dilators for the elevation of the upper eyelid. Occipital frontalis, occipital to the frontal, that is elevating the upper eyelid, and levator palpebral superioris, levator elevation of the palpebral eyelid superioris above the mouth. So this is about the splinters and the dilators of the palpebral fissure. Next, splinter of the nostrils. Here, one is present, that is for the closing of the nose. That is a compressor. It is a compressing, compressor naris. And three are the dilators here. That is a dilator means, if you are angry movement, then your nose will be going to the dilator. Dilators. Dilators are dilator, naris, depressor, septi. Here is present depressor, septi. And medial slip of the levator labi superioris alveoli nasal. That's why I explained it is present in the either side of the nose, alveoli nasi, that is using for the dilation of the nose. This is called dilation and this is called a compression. One splinter and rest of the dilators. We completed the palpebral fissure and the nostril fissure. Come to about the oral. In the oral, this is called a closing of the mouth. Splinter and rest of the article are openings, opening of the mouth. This splinter is the orbicularis oris, and dilators are the rest of the all the muscles around the mouth. Rest of the all the muscles are using for the dilation of the mouth, except the one muscle is the mentalis. Mentalis is present here, that is not involved in the dilation of the mouth. Only one muscle is involved in the closing of the mouth. It is called a orbicularis oris. And rest of the all the muscles around the mouth, those are the dilators except the mentalis. So this is about the functionally. So we completed the developmentally, morphologically, topographically and the functionally. See, this facial muscles is not important for that much, and for your examination point of view, only two muscles are important. One is the buccinator and second one is the platysma. Here I am not explaining the origin and insertion of the, all these muscles. Just I am showing directly about the facial expression. Then the most important one, not important for it is for the facial expressions. So how the Nadeshwar and Neha Madam, Shima Madam, everyone is understanding your facial expression based on this muscles of the face. So see here, one is smiling and the laughing. That is by the zygomatic major. Sadness. Sadness means, for example, if you are failing your examination, your first session examination, take your example for your first session. Or your levator labii superioris and the levator anguli oris. That will be means your angle, you are looking like this. Sad. So two muscles are involved in the sadness. And next is called like this. Grip means, what is mean of gripping? The gripping means somebody is a suddenly death. It means oversadness. That is called a gripping. It is by the depressor anguli oris. Completely your angle will be going to the lower. I will show you one by one. And next is the anger. Anger means, you know, gussa aa jata hai sab log ko. So that is called a dilator nares. You are dilating your nose. And the depressor septa, zygomatic major, smiling and the laughing. People are smiling and the laughing. The muscle is involved in the action is called a facial expression is called a zygomatic major. And the next, sadness. So when I see you, sadness. By the two muscles, levator labii superioris and the levator anguli oris. Next is the gripping. Means somebody is a death. Someone, your known person is a death. At the time, your angle will be depressed. That is called a depressor anguli oris. Oris means the mouth. Next. Surprise, no comfortable with surprise. Your pass in your first session examination or your pass in the upcoming examination, that is surprise for you, not for me. So at the time, you have the appearance of the wrinkles here. See, wrinkles. That is called, that is by the frontalis muscle. Next one. Doubt. I think this is not for you people. Because you know, you all are the well knowledge people and you don't have any doubts. But some students have the doubts, not less than 10 students out of 150 students. The doubt is by the mentalis. See here. It is creating the doubt. Next. Frowning. Frowning means, what is the meaning of frowning? Frowning means argument. You are arguing with your teachers. You are having the less mark in your PCT. One question they are allotted in, not allotted any marks. Then you are arguing with your teachers. Teacher, this is the correct one. So at the time, you were these two lines. See, this is the action. The two vertical lines will be appear. See here. Vertical lines by the one muscle, that is called a corrugator supercilii and the procerus. That is called the frowning argument. Next, horror, terror, and fright by the platysma. You are watching the horror movie, and somebody has terrorized you. At the time, the neck part will be going to the tight. And you are going to the shout. You are watching the horror movies. by the platysmums. And next is the grinning. The next action is the grinning. What is the meaning of grinning? Some animals like monkeys. Monkeys are the grinning. So that's why the teachers he said, don't laugh like a monkeys. So means is the showing of your teeth completely by the one muscle that is called the rhizoris. The next action is the zygomatic minor, that is the contempt. What is the meaning of contempt? It is insulting. For example, if you visit any court, the judge is announcing, don't contempt the court. Means it is the insulting of the court. For example, if your friends also you are insulting you. Chalo, jaane do. That is called insulting. So like, which mother is involved? Here is the zygomatic mind. See here, contempt is the one more photograph is there here. The contempt here, the angle of the mouth is going to the one side. We are seeing na, they are not alerted any mark. Jaane do yaar, nahin. That is the insulting of the someone. Next is the closing of the mouth. Closing of the mouth. Basically closing of. Because of the orbicularis ovaris. Next muscle. See here is the closing of the mouth. Next is called a bezeling by the two muscles. One is called a buccinator and orbicularis ovaris. Your friend birthday or your birthday. You are first you are puffing with the candles. And then you are going to the whistle. You are attending any celebrations or you are going to watch any movie, you are whistling by the two muscles. One is the buccinator and second is the orbicularis ovaris. Next we discuss about the platysma origin and the insertion. And origin, it is upper part of the pectoral and the deltoid fascia. Here is the pectoralis muscle is present, pectoral fascia, and it is called the deltoid fascia. So in this part, this fascia's continuation forms the muscle that is called the platysma. See, fibres are running upward and the medially. The fibres is running upward and the medially, like this, upward, medial side, and inserted into the base of the mandible. The fibres are inserted into the base of the mandible, along with the posterior fibres to the skin of the lower face and the lips. Here the anterior fibres are inserted in this part. In this place, say posterior fibres are present. The posterior fibres are inserted into the skin of the lower face and the lips, up to the lip region. So this is about the platysma origin and insertion. Next action, I think you know about the action that is called horror, terror, and the frightening. So this is about the platysma. Next come to about the testing of the muscles. Clinical testing of the muscles. First we test the frontalis. We ask the patient sit in the chair and look upward direction. See, this is looking upward side. Without his head is moving any direction. And when we is looking upward direction, the vertical lines is appears. If this vertical lines appears, means his frontalis muscle is fine. Otherwise, they are having the problem of the frontalis. Next, the next one is the muscle is called the corrugator supercilii and the procerus. How we can test the corrugator supercilii and the procerus? The action of these two muscles is the frowning. Frowning means argument. If you are arguing with anybody, the vertical lines appear here. Here vertical lines appear. If these vertical lines appear, means his corrugator supercilii is fine. Otherwise, having the problem. Then next is the orbicularis oculi. It is around the eye. Ask the patient to close his eyes. If he is closed, then the muscle is fine. Otherwise, having the problem with the orbicularis oculi. Then same next is the orbicularis oris. Ask the patient to close this mouth. Is able to do that part means having the fine that muscle, otherwise having the problem. Next, ask the patient to the whistling. Whistling or puffing. So he is going to whistle, means his buccinator is fine in condition. Clear? And one more is the platysma. Here we can compress this part. So here the lines is appear. If these are the appears, then our platysma is fine. Otherwise, there is a problem with the platysma. So these are the testing of the clinical testing of muscles of the face. Next is the nerve supply of the face. The nerve supply of the face, only one nerve supplies here, that is a motor nerve is the facial nerve. And one more is the sensory nerve supplies, that is the trigeminal. First, talk about the facial nerve. The facial nerve having the 5 branches. Those branches are the temporal, zygomatic, upper buccal, lower buccal, marginal, and the cervical. Only 5 branches. Upper and lower buccal consider only one buccal branch. And this branches of the facial nerve. First, take your hand and hold it in your ear. The thumb finger going to the upper direction, that is called a temporal branch. And this is called an index finger, zygomatic branch. And this one is the above the upper lip, is the buccal branch. And below the lower lip, that is the mandibular branch. And last we have the cervical branch. So how can we remember this all the names? Here is our mnemonic is there. Telangana, Jindabad, Bombay, Municipal Corporation. Telangana, Jindabad, Bombay, Municipal Corporation. So Telangana means temporal, Jindabad, zygomatic. Bombay, buccal, municipal, mandible, corporation, cervical. So this temporal is supplies to the, here is the muscle surface. That muscles are around the eye and the auricular muscles, supplied by the temporal branch. And next is called zygomatic branch, supplying the around the eye, along with the zygomatic part. Zygomatic major and the zygomatic minor, and upper buccal and the lower buccal supplies to the around the mouth, and fourth one is called a mandibular supply in the mandibular region, and fifth one is cervical supplies to the platysma. So this is about the motor branch of the facial nerve. Next, let us discuss about the palsy. So here in the diagram, these two are the brain part, that is called as cortex, and this is called a nucleus, facial nerve nucleus present in the brain stem. Okay, and below it supplies to the face. If any lesion means is called a damage, injury. Above this nucleus injured, that is called a supranuclear lesion, and below the nucleus is the infranuclear lesion. So for example, if the cut in this part below the nucleus, what is called as an infranuclear lesion. So what happens in the infranuclear lesion? That infranuclear lesion we call as a Bell's palsy. In this condition, he lost the facial expression of same side. Not this side, this side of the face is clear. This side is getting the paralysis. Same side get paralysis. If the nuclear present here, if cut in this place, so this side will be getting the paralysis, not in the opposite side. Because from above cortex to which are the nerve fibers reaches, those nerve fibers reach to the nucleus supplies to the same site. So in his Bell's palsy, the wrinkles are disappears. Which side of the paralysis? The wrinkles are disappear, and eye cannot closed. And third one, if he is going to the spine, that will be going to the opposite side. And if he is eating something, that is clenched between the same side only, and that not shifting to the opposite side. And he lost all the facial expressions. That is called Bell's palsy. I think the more about the Bell's palsy explained by the clinicians in your vertical integration class. If the supranuclear lesion means above the nucleus. So lesion is appears here. But opposite face in the lower part of the face get paralyzed. How? Sir, 1 and 2, these two fibers are reached to the opposite direction. Here, from here to two more nerves are supplied to the, one is going to the upper direction and one is going to the lower part. So the lower part fibers and upper part fibers both get paralyzed. But only lower part of the face going to the paralyzed, because this upper part, again it's supplied by the same side one more nerve. That's why this part is escaped from the paralysis. On the lower part will be getting going to the paralysis. That is a supranuclear lesion. And next we have the trigeminal nerve. That is a sensory nerve. Supplies to the complete face. Especially nasal cavity and paranasal air sinuses. Maxillary sinuses, ethmoidal sinuses, and the frontal sinuses. Along with, it supplies to the around the eye, around the mouth, and the gums or gum, anterior to that of the tongue, and along with the cheeks. The cheek region also supplied by the trigeminal nerve. So, what is the trigeminal headache? Commonly we have the headache because of this sensory nerve supply of the face. All are the same symptoms, like if you are having the common cold supplied by the nose, so that it leads to the headache, and infection of the sinuses, that also leads to the headache. And if you have any eye problems, glaucoma, so that is also reached to the headache. So headache is the most common thing in the trigeminal nerve, which is the face will be affected, which is the face sensation will be affected, that will be appear in the having the headache. The next is the trigeminal neuralgia. What is the trigeminal neuralgia? Trigeminal nerve having the three branches. One is the ophthalmic, supplies to the eye, one is the mandibular, and second one, third one is the maxillary. Three branches. If any problem in the trigeminal ganglia, that we call it the trigeminal neuralgia. Example is the famous actor, the Hindi actor, the Salman Khan. He also having of the trigeminal neuralgia. That is called as suicidal disease. The other name is we call it the suicidal disease. So, at the time we are having the burning and heavy pain in our mind. It's like we are going to the suicide. Why we are not going to the suicide? That's why it is called a suicidal disease. How we can treat it? So, we treated 90% of the alcoholic that we are injecting into the nerve root. The first one. And second way again treatment is called a sectioning of the nerve. Sectioning of the nerve. The above the medulla, this trigeminal neuralgia also well explained by your clinician on the vertical integration class. Please don't ask me and my personal number. Thank you.